Hi, today we are next to my Volvo V50 and we are going to check a new tool that I just got from Ancel. This is a power probe which comes with a lot of accessories inside and a lot of wiring, and right now I'm worried that I will not fit that back inside the suitcase. First of all, we have the actual probe with few meters of wiring. There's a cigarette lighter adapter, crocodile clips to connect directly to your battery, few more meters of extension cord. There's also a user manual which explains a lot actually, and that's not that common when it comes to diagnostic tools. There are a lot of examples how to use it and what is each feature designed for, so let's get to it. Let's start with connecting to the battery using the crocodile clips. The device powers up automatically, there's no battery inside, so if your car's battery is completely flat, then you'll need to find another power source for it. There are two LEDs to use as a flashlight at the top, color LCD screen, and switched bidirectional switch, one button over here, ground lid, and over here we have the probe which goes over here. With the red button you change modes of the tool, and with the switch you can connect the probe to the positive or the negative terminal. So when I press it upwards, I have 12 volts over here, and when I press it downwards, I have ground connection over here. And when I don't press anything, I can just measure the voltage by touching with the probe to the connection. Okay, so let's check it out. So let's check the voltage again. I have 12.2, and I should get the same readout when I touch the probe to the positive terminal on the battery. Okay, now let's check the negative lead. And it indicates that I have a connection to ground. So now let's check the cigarette lighter output. I can see if there's ground. Yeah, and now I'm touching the positive terminal, and since my ignition is off, I get a ground reading. So let's turn the ignition on, and it changes to 12 volts. Cabin fuse's location in Volvo V50 is extremely uncomfortable for me, so the flashlight feature in this is very useful. It's the first time that I'm checking fuses, and I can actually see what I'm doing. And even if the position is so difficult that I can't see the screen, I can still hear the beep, which confirms that there's a connection to the ground or to the positive side of the battery. Thanks to the additional ground lead, you don't have to check components that are installed in the car. You can use it to, for example, connect a fuse to the lid and use the probe to check if there's continuity. And you know that this fuse is okay. Checking voltages and fuses is fairly easy, so let's try to use the ground lid to try to activate some components. So over here I have a 12 volt fan, and I'm going to connect one of the wires to the ground lid and use the probe to connect to the plus side. And as you can see, nothing happens because I didn't activate the voltage. And now I can see that the fan works. And the same goes with LEDs. And we can also check components that are installed in the car, like those lights over here. Some equipment of your car, like dome light with a fade-in and fade-out effect, are usually connected to a permanent 12-volt connection and are controlled with the ground connection. So if we measure the lead over here, we can see that we have 12 volts and we can activate this light with the ground connection. In Volvo you can turn on and off the lights with the remote, and as you can see we have a nice dim in and dim out effect. So let's check with the probe what's the signal like when I turn on the lights. So let's switch to AC voltage. Let's connect over here. We can hear from the buzzer and see on the graph the pulses that are making the fade in and the fade out effect. This is useful when you are trying to diagnose devices like vacuum valves, which are controlled with PWM signals, and you want to see if the signal is actually correct. Back at the engine, there's a vacuum valve over here. This is responsible for controlling the variable geometry turbine in the Volvo 2.0 diesel engine. And here's the connector that I just disconnected from this valve. Now I'm going to turn on the ignition and check what are the signals going through this cable, through this connector to the valve. This is how the signal looks like. We have a 250 Hz frequency, give or take, and we have pulses that will control the vacuum valve. Now let's switch to the resistance and we can check some sensors. If they work correctly, we can use the auxiliary lead to connect to a better ground connection that is closer to the sensor or to the sensor itself if we don't have the wiring connected to the sensor. So here I have the temperature sensor, the intake temperature sensor, and there are two wires over here. One is ground and the other one is the signal that goes back to the engine control module. So I can use the probe to stick it over here and I get a readout. And I got a readout of 3.4 kilo ohms. Now I would have to check if that readout is correct for this temperature, this ambient temperature that we have right now over here. Okay, that's it. I'm going to try to fit it back inside the suitcase. And meanwhile, you can check the description below this video if you want to buy one of those Ancel PB100 probes. Also, give me a thumbs up if you liked this review. Subscribe to my channel for future videos and check my other videos because I made a lot of tutorials for lots of brands and lots of issues. Thank you for watching and see you soon!